Okay, one is combinational circuit, the other one is sequential circuit. The second one is sequential circuit. Here flip flops R comes under the sequential circuit. So before that you have to know about what is combinational circuit. Here the in combinational circuit the output depends upon only present input, but in sequential circuit the output depend upon present input and previous output. Okay, this is shown in the slide. You have here we have combinational circuit and memory element. Combination circuit, it is nothing but all logic gates are involved. Here memory elements are called latches. Okay, so here the example of sequential circuits are flip-flop, registers and counters. So today we are going to see about different types of flip-flop. We have four types of flip-flop. First one is SR flip-flop, and second one is D flip-flop, and third one is JK flip-flop, and fourth one is T flip-flop. Here we have some disadvantages of flip-flop in JK flip-flop. To overcome that disadvantages in JK flip-flop, we go for master slave flip-flop. Okay, first of all you have to know about what is the latch operation. So I give the circuit diagram for latch circuit. This is the latch circuit construction. We are constructing latch circuit using NAND gate and NOR gate. Okay, here I am using NOR gate. So here we are using two NOR gates. Before that you have to know what is the working operations of NOR gate. Suppose if you give one input to the NOR gate as 1, you will get the output as 0. Okay, this is the NOR gate symbol. Y is the output. Y is equal to a plus b whole bar. So if any one input of NOR gate is 1, you will get the output is 0. So this concept is very important for the construction of SR latch, and this concept is used in flip flop. So here the function table of SR flip flop. S and R are two inputs. So we have two inputs 00, 01, 10, 11. If you are using two variables, we have four possible combinations of inputs. Suppose if you give S and R both are 00, you will get previous output. That means you will get no change output. Suppose if you give 0 and 1, you will get the output as 0. Suppose if you give set input as 1 and our reset input as 0, you will get the output 1. If you give both inputs are 1, 1, you will get invalid state output. What is mean by invalid? Here the latch circuit has two output variable Q and Q bar. So if one output is 1, the other output is 0. So if you give both inputs are 1, you won't get the output. So we will call it as invalid. But this invalid output can be obtained by JK flip-flop. That output is called toggle output. Okay, this latch circuit is very, very important. So using this latch circuit, we are constructing SR flip-flop. So this is SR flip-flop. Here we are using latch circuit for using NAND gate, NOR gate. Here two inputs are S and R, then we are giving clock pulse to the SR flip-flop, but latch circuit has no clock pulse. But in the flip-flop, we are using clock signals. This is the logic diagram for SR flip-flop. Here, that is, we are using SR latch, and we give S and R input by using AND gate, and we are giving clock pulse to AND gate. Suppose if both inputs are S and R are 00, you will get the output. What is the output of AND gate? If any one input of AND gate is 0, that means the AND gate, and what is the operation of AND gate? It produces the product operation. So if any one input of AND gate is 0, you will get the output is 0. So when S and R both are 0, clock pulse is 1, you will get the output 0, 0. But previous, if you are giving the previous value of your flip-flop is 0, you will get the output as 0. So you will get the no change operation. That is, I give the functioning table Q, S, R. Q is the previous output and S and R present input. Then Q of T plus 1 is called present output. So for these combinations, we are giving 4 combinations of input. So previous output, we assume all 4 combinations of input 0. So for 0, 0, 0, you will get the output 0. Suppose if you give 0 and S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, you will get the output 1. Okay. But if you give both input S and R are 1, you will get the indeterminate or invalid state. Then we give, when S equal to 1 and R equal to 0, for that, in that combination, previous output we assume 1 for all these 4 combinations of input. So for both inputs are 1 in the flip-flop, you will get the indeterminate. If we give both inputs are 0, you will get the no change condition. That means whatever you got the output in the previous, it will be maintaining. So output 1 is maintained in the Q. So if S is equal to 1, you will get the output 1. If preset is 1, you will get the output 0. This is the working operation of SR flip-flop. Before the construction is, that is here we are using 2 AND gates. The clock pulse is always high and S and R both inputs and Q bar are 2 outputs. Okay. Next type flip-flop, D flip-flop. Here in this flip-flop, you are giving only 1 input. Here D is directly given to the S input and the complement of D flip-flop is given to the reset. That means R input. Okay. This is the logic diagram D flip-flop. Here we are constructing. This is the construction of D flip-flop. Here we are using latch circuit using NOR gate. We can also use latch circuit with NAND gate also. But here we are using, I am NOR gate only, I am using NOR latch, I am using. Here D is one input, here that D is directly given to S input and complemented output is given to R input. So whenever D is 0, you will get the output 0, whatever may be the previous output. When D is equal to 1, it will give the output 1. Suppose if D is 1 and previous output also 1, you will get the output also 1. So here, when D is 1, that is you are applying S equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. For previous SR flip-flop, when S equal to 1, R equal to 0, you will get the output 1. Here also, when D is equal to 1, you will get the output. But when D is 0, you won't get the output. So you will get the output 0. This is JK flip-flop. In JK flip-flop, it is similar to SR flip-flop. Here, all 3 combinations of input, you will get the same output as in SR flip-flop. But if you are giving, when J and K are both inputs are 1, you will get the toggle output. That means indeterminate output is avoided by using JK flip-flop. Indeterminate output is produced in SR flip-flop. This output can be modified by using JK flip-flop. So what is the modification of the JK flip-flop circuit? This is the construction of JK flip-flop. Here we give the feedback loop